C minor then becomes this watershed, I think, in the concertos, where you suddenly see two worlds colliding, or a crossroads of worlds. You see Beethoven paying homage to the great C minor Mozart concerto 491. There's no question about that. But on the other hand, it opens the floodgates for this kind of total and deep romanticism, a kind of newfound desire to express ever more extreme uses of the piano in various registers. And suddenly you see this whole new world opening. We know, I think, from Ries, who turned pages for the third concerto, that basically Beethoven was reading from a manuscript that had almost nothing, just the vaguest sketch of a piano part. I think it calls into question the basic idea of what it means to play a piano concerto, in the sense that in the 18th century and the beginning of the 19th century, the piano concerto, if it wasn't published, remained largely in the head of the composer.
Yes, Signor, Beethoven. Saying that. Dat kan nog meer zijn. Het is de retorische formule van een gebonden octaaf. Het moet altijd iets juichends zijn. Wow!
Beethoven is less problematic in that department because we do have first editions for these pieces, but I maintain that the reality of what actually happened in one of those performances is far from indicated in the texts that we have. Now, this could be what Beethoven did in the cadenzas, what he does in repeats of themes, whether he ornaments them, whether or not he plays continuo with the orchestra, what he does when he plays continuo.
Thank you.